like a big match, people. Food's still coming in. We'll wait until we get mace found into the body of the kirk before we start. Thank you. wait for another 5 minutes, folks. The march is still coming in. Conservative estimates are saying 15,000. Looks a lot bigger to me. It's certainly going to be the biggest independence march since the outbreak of COVID. Absolutely no doubt. By the way, I've got a phone here with a salt tire cover. The stage. So who said that the independence movement was dead, eh?
Shut up your eyes! Independence!
All right, okay. No worries. That had to happen at some point.
Yeah.
I have a funny feeling they popped her up. Not really good. They popped her up. I checked the cables just now.
Such a jump, there's no looking match up.
Yeah.
Well, there's a lot of coverage.
guys aren't sitting there with your phones watching you. What's going on? Are you recording it for later?
Oh, yeah. I'm not interested in what's going on.
Everyone who does these things always get that extra 3 dB, the extra 3 dB until it just looks.
The march seems to be coming to an end now. I mean, I'm an arborist supporter, throwing crowds above 2,000 I have a bit of difficulty in estimating. But certainly it's got to be 20,000 plus. Definitely. I'd just like to welcome everybody here. Can you hear me in the back? Typical Glasgow day, the rain's coming down.
anyone wants to talk, we've got some.
I'd just like to welcome everybody here. Can you hear me at the back now? Can you hear me now? That's better, is it? Well, we're certainly looking at a march here around 20,000. The largest march since the outbreak of COVID and the independence movement. fighting, mate. And now they say that we can't even run our own affairs. We have been gaslit. We have been gaslit with the mother of all historical gaslighting. They're turning us into wee pear traitors. Well, we are no wee pear traitors. We are Job Thompson's parents. We should never forget that.
Feels like I was here about half an hour ago. There's a song called Independence Day. Scots hometown. Mandela! Freedom swim. Where the fascist chants and racist rants. Hatred was in the air. For the old John Bull with the Biden rule. Had primed that mob with hate. With their ignorance and indifference. They were shown to take the bait. Put bold and stay face against the violent mass. Johnson says, still. And held aloft the St. Andrew's cross. A flag of nation hope. Did not flinch, nor give an inch. To the mob, they show no fear. But stood their ground and cried aloud. They were so tired, remains here. Well, the mob, they attacked and they kicked and they punched and they spat. And although you disagreed, or had campaigns through peaceful gain, for a country to be free. Every time you hold their numbers soared, and the soiled Scottish air. But you want to spend his sisters in arms, or drive them from the square. For bold and stay fierce against the violent mass. Johnson says, still. Held aloft the St. Andrew's cross, flag of nation hope. Well, it took the police to intervene and march those girls away. In the jail that night for a crime they would not say. Sarah and Sophie Johnson, remember those sisters' names, for they represent a future. Keep the fire aflame. They defy the fascist bigots. You represent the past and cling to a dying union. Although the dice is cast, for bullets they faced against the violent mass. Johnson says, still. The sailor's cross with a flame, we shall hope. It did not flinch, nor give an inch to the mob, they showed no fear. But it stood their ground and they cried aloud. The soldier remains here. Yeah, the soldier. Remains here, in some time, remains here.
Right, folks, thanks very much for having me. And, sorry about the rain and all that. Hey, take care, all the best, thank you.
contributions of former leadership. We must learn from the mistakes made and address these issues with justice, compassion, and reconciliation. The time has come for a fresh start, grounded in integrity, unity, and an unwavering commitment to our cause and our people. I refuse to compromise In the 27 countries of the EU, how many of them have a big fancy coronation ceremony like what there will be today? How many? None! None! That is how weird what is happening down the road is. Weird. There are 21 republics of the 27 EU states. That's who we are. Amongst the six who have got monarchs, they don't have these ceremonies. The majority of them get the monarch to come to their parliament, you know, elected democratically, that old one, right? And they swear allegiance to the parliament. Now, this is why then is Britain so different? Because that's what it has to be. The mystique, the mystery, the braid, the medals, the gongs, the archaic nonsense, the weird hopping on one leg. It's all Britain has. And it's fine. We're not here to provide free entertainment for the rest of the world. It's fine for them to look in and think, wow, this is amazing. We'd have nothing like this in our country. It's like watching upstairs, downstairs. The point is, they don't have to live in it. We do. And we're not having it. It's not who we are. Now, there's another wee thing about this, about the weirdness. You might look around the world and see that there are still 15 Commonwealth realms that have the king or the queen as their head of state. Why is that? Because they spent Barbados 2021 declared itself a republic. Yes. How long did it take Barbados, tiny of Barbados, to unweave the constitutional network that British officials had placed within their written constitution when they were allowed to be free in 1966? It took them 40 years. That is how thick the constitutional mesh is, and that is what's keeping these guys with kings and queens as their head of state from a distant country like here. So the next country to go will be Jamaica. They'll go in 2025, but what have they got in their constitution? The British placed a requirement that they need a two-thirds vote to be able to abolish the monarchy. So let's just say they're cute, right? We're not the only people who are finding it extremely hard to have a straightforward expression of our democratic will. But they will do it. And after them, the tiny Bahamas. So things are on the move. The world's on the move. This kind of cravenness, this doffing your cap, this crawling, all this stuff is part of a world that is gone. Britain will never catch up because it cannot let go of that imperial past. It's all it can see. We can see everything else. We can see all the possibilities for ourselves. We can see the possibility that we will be an independent country alongside a reunited Ireland, alongside an independent Wales, and alongside an independent England. And not only will we be in that fabulous situation, an independent country in a new revamped Council of the Isles, we will also be in the Nordic Council, because that's who we are as well. We are a North Atlantic social democratic state in the making, in the waiting, and we've waited long enough. So that's what this is all about. And the bard was quoted earlier. There's a different verse that comes to me from A Man's a Man, which is looking at, you see yon birkie called a lord, wha struts and stares and all that, though hundreds worship at his word, he's but a goof for all that. For all that and all that, his ribbon star and all that, the folk of independent mind, they look and laugh at all that.
requires an introduction for me. I remember at the height of the attacks on him, he stood up and he says, "You've not seen the last of the bonnets of me, and you see that Alex Salmond is back, and he's back with a bang." Who here would rather be undercover? up for too long. Brat, I see him back.
See him back to me.
Now, we're going to hear a wee short musical interlude now. I mean, you've got in for a rare treat. We've got some great speakers coming up, so hope you hang on. We've got Joanne Cherry, a Bonnie Fechter, if ever there was one for the independence movement. And we've got Craig Murray. We ought to owe a debt of gratitude to Craig Murray for the work that he has done.
Yeah.
Before we get there, we've got the Chymatics. They're a folk roots band from Aberdeen. Now, I'd never heard of them before, so I googled them and listened to them last night. I'm telling you, you're in for a right treat, and I was listening to their sound check. They're very, very good. I was asking the lead singer there if Chymatics, if the word chi's got anything to do with coos. But apparently it's not, and I thought, well, that's probably just as well, because if it was Aberdeen, it should have been really about sheep. Anyway, I'll hand over to the Chymatics. You're in for a real treat here, folks.
The sun come down upon a world still known. this borderline.
You know.
and your folks.
Yeah! This next song we need your help with. We're sure you'll all know the words. But also, before we finish up, we're just going to do a little jig. Going in Scotland. So halfway through this song, we're gonna link arms and we're gonna spin each other around as fast as we can, okay? And I'm coming down over that fence there. I'm joining you, okay? So you better be ready for me.
Thank you.
tell you though, kid. great wee speech that Anne Mullins, keeping the tradition of radical Scottish medical and professionals alive, well and kicking. The next speaker that we've got today is Mohammed Asif. Mohammed is an Afghan refugee, a political refugee who fled Afghanistan in 2000. He's made his home in Glasgow.
Thank you, brothers and sisters. I'm a bit loud. Thank you for coming today. Me coming here as a refugee 23 years ago, it was just like yesterday. A young man, but still very young, and have melted into the Scottish community of proud Scots now. When I say independence, you ask me that we fought for our country in Afghanistan for many, many years. I know how it feels when you have a country. I know how it feels when you have your own identity. And I know how it feels when you call a country home. And that home was taken from us in Afghanistan, you know, in many, many different wars. But now here in Scotland, we together, I think the biggest weakness right now is the division among us. We have to come united. If we want to have a future for our children and grandchildren, you will be responsible when your grandchild goes to school and read your history. He will blame you, she will blame you, that my grandfather did not fight enough for my country. So we have to come together and fight the imperialist policies, the policies that destroyed many, many countries around the world, brothers and sisters. You remember what happened in my country, 21 years of failed war by Britain and America and NATO, and after 23 years, you know, Boris Johnson ran away in the middle of the night, abandoned the people of Afghanistan. Brothers and sisters, when hundreds of thousands of people on the streets of Glasgow in Scotland, I remember in this park when we started marching against the illegal war in Iraq, and we were saying to the then war criminal, Tony Blair, that the war in Iraq was illegal. When the people of Scotland was telling Tony Blair and Bush that the war in Iraq is illegal, and the people of Scotland will not take responsibility in Iraq. But we were told that the Scots don't matter. Brothers and sisters, we need to stay united, to have our future. When again, the Brexit, remember, when we were saying, the Scots were saying, if we want, you know, to be part of Europe, we were told that we will die of hunger. We will die of hunger, but now we know that the people who destroyed our livelihood, our future generation, you know, the cost of living crisis, the energy crisis, the petrol crisis, the mortgage crisis, and it's you and me who are blamed. Not the Tories and not in others, and they have created these crises, brothers and sisters. 1 minute, brother, for the last time. You know, I am a refugee, and now currently we have a racist regime led by the Tories in this country, brothers and sisters, blaming refugees for their own failure, the failure on mortgage crisis, the cost of living crisis, the energy crisis, and everything is blame on the refugees. We are called the invaders. We are called the invaders, imagine. I tell you about an invasion when P-52 is, you know, flying on your head, killing your family and your children, you know, displacing millions of people. That is an invasion, brothers and sisters. And when we say that we welcome our brothers and sisters from Ukraine, But now if you're an Afghan and if you're a product of the illegal war, if you're an Iraqi and you're a product of the illegal war, if you're a Libyan or Syrian or Yemeni, when you come to this country, brothers and sisters, you will be detained by the Tories and sent to Rwanda. So my appeal to everyone, brothers and sisters, in this country, in this city, please come together. Fight for our future, for our children. On the 21st of May, we are going to protest, you know, in front of a hotel in Erskine, because the far right are protesting every day against the refugees. So I will ask everyone to join us on the 21st of May in Erskine to say no to the Nazis in Scotland. Scotland is a country which is welcoming, which welcomed me, my family and many, many others. God bless Scotland and long live Scotland. Thank you.
Those rights are under attack. Day after day, the Tories plot and plan to take away the rights. They want a minimum wage, 0 hour workforce. They want to make it easy to get rid of you without any comeback. They want a workforce who are afraid to answer them back. They want a workforce who are afraid to get sick. And they want a workforce stripped of their right to strike. Winning. The minimum service levels bill may have been pushed back by the House of Lords in England, but ultimately the Tory government can and will bring it back, and it will be enacted, removing the right to strike from hundreds of thousands of people across the country. And if you cannot strike, then what are you? You're a slave, that's what you are. So what can you do? Well, for starters, join a union. Gain the protection that your trade union provides and help to organise and ensure that you and your fellow workers get the pay, terms and conditions that you deserve, not what your bosses think that they can get away with giving you. And when you do join your union, get active. By linking arms with the Tories in 2014, some trade unions caused immeasurable damage to the trade union movement. So be the voice. voice of the independence movement in your union and never let that happen again. Otherwise, the parcel of rogues in the Labour Party will speak on your behalf. They won't be speaking in your interest. In the short term, the election of a Labour government in Westminster might provide some respite from this by reversing some legislation. But be under no illusions. The Tories will be back. And they can reverse anything that the Labour Party does. Of course, we wouldn't be in this mess. The British Nationalist Labour Party in Scotland had blocked the devolution of employment legislation under the Smith Commission in 2014. But that's the small print of Better Together that they would rather you forget. If you take one thing away from today, it's remember this. Don't fall for Labour's false promises. And that short-term answer, by the way, doesn't solve Scotland's problems. And all it does is push it a bit further down the line. Pushes independence down the line. And when the Tories return, and they will, it'll be too late. The answer to Scotland's problems will not be found by falling into line with England. Be found by stepping out into the world ourselves and taking decisions for ourselves and accepting responsibility for the outcomes of those decisions, be they good or bad. And when we do finally take that massive step, we must start off that new chapter in Scottish history by immediately implementing the lessons that we've learned over Scotland's recent past. We must put an end to the professional political class which exists across our Parliament. It is simply unacceptable that we can have professional politicians like Myrtle Fraser who can receive rejection after rejection from the electorate and yet repeatedly end up on the public bus. 2 terms as a listed MSP and you should be out the door. Likewise, we must end the use of the list as a safety net for failed politicians who the public vote out of office, such as Elaine Smith of Labour, who after being voted out in Coatbridge, jumped onto the list and sat as a list MSP until she would retire, taking her pension with her. That has to stop. Our politicians need a reminder that we, the people of Scotland, are sovereign, not them. Speaking of sovereigns, we don't need them either. When Betty Windsor died, we were told, now is not the time to discuss the future with the monarchy. Well, behind the scenes, the ruling classes were ensuring that there was, as one commentator put it, a seamless transition of power. We live here in the Central Belt, where sectarianism is still a massive problem. The R word is a divisive term which sends one side into a froth and rage, another side will cheer and give you a wee wink. It's time we could have a grown-up discussion about republicanism and becoming a republic. There is nothing wrong with being a republic and nothing wrong with being a republican. The dictionary defines a republic as being a state in which the supreme power is held by the people and their elected representatives, which is an elected or nominated president rather than a monarch. And in the 21st century, shouldn't we be looking to join the other 159 republics in the world, not the 40-odd monarchies? If there's one thing that we can learn from Betty's brood, it's that their family can be every bit as dysfunctional as the next. They are nothing special, and it's high time we stop treating them as such. So get off your knees, Scotland. Stop doffing your caps and start treating the majesties, the sons, the lords and the ladies with the contempt that they deserve. Demand independence for Scotland and down with the crown!
Amen to that. Great speech again there, Peter. You should remind the SDUC
heels into the ground and wouldn't be moved. My admiration for her has increased enormously over the last 3 years. Give a great hand again for Joanna Cherry.
Well, hi everyone. It's really great to be back marching with all under one banner again. I did have an invitation to put my name in the ballot for the coronation, but as anyone who knows me would have guessed, I'd much rather be here with you today than at Westminster. Because, my friends, today is a particularly good day to remind the British establishment that in Scotland, it is the people who are sovereign. Party with a proud history.
Now, before the travel from junk band come on, we've got a wee speech, 2 or 3 minutes, and then there's some technical stuff around the stage as well. It's a good friend and comrade of mine for Dundee. He's a welfare worker, a long-standing supporter of Scottish independence. This is the first big speech he's done at an event like this. So give him a good rousing indie welcome to Alan Hendricks for Dundee.
Thank you.
us, we need to do that. And if they tell us they want answers, we need to give them answers. And if they tell us that we want to understand how this makes their life better, we need to tell them how this makes their life better. We spend too long gazing at our own tables and worrying about what we are going to do. And it is time now to get the work done, to turn ourselves outwards to the voters that we need to engage with. We need to talk to them, we need to ask them, and we need to work. And if we do that, if we get that together, we recognise what we've got and what we have to do. We've got the skills, the talent, and my God, we've got the enthusiasm, the numbers to put this debate. So yes, I'm talking to a lot of people just now, and they've got their heads down, and they're worried. And there's people in the newspapers saying it's over for a generation, and it could be. And the difference between it being over and not being over is one simple thing. It's us. We do this or we don't. We fix this or we don't. And I'll tell you one thing to finish up. We are now in a situation where no one is coming to rescue us. There is no white knight on a horse coming over the hill. We cannot just get ourselves down to the beach, light a rescue fire and hope someone comes. Nobody's coming. It's down to us. We will take this by the scruff of the neck. We will get it together and we will win it or we won't. It's down to us. Stop looking over your shoulder. Stop asking who's going to fix this. We will fix this. And when we do, we will deliver that Scotland that all of us want. But I don't have to drive in here with my eyes closed, hoping that I won't see houses absolutely festooned with Union Jacks, because it breaks my heart. Work like you're in the early days of a better world. Nobody ever said anything better. But right now, independence movement, work like you know we can deliver this. We can deliver this soon. Don't lose faith. We will do this. Thanks, everybody.
Stop there for Robin McCall. Next speaker, Liverpool.
talking about the similarity between pandas at Edinburgh Zoo.
£45 and 50p.
was the last time I played it? That was over 9 years ago. It's probably went up by now. Stop your license, BBC.
one Willie McCrae. Willie, wherever you are, I hope you're watching us, because we're going to finish what you started. Right, here's a question. Why are we all here today, instead of watching, along with millions of others worldwide, the coronation of Chuck the Third? Maybe it's because we're offended by the spectacle of the ruling class parading its God-given right to reign over us through the symbolism of an English feudal ceremony. If you want something to make the point of all that symbolism a bit clearer, it's written on a plaque across from St. Bartholomew's Hospital in London, at the site where William Wallace was tortured to death. It says, "Serve and obey." Is that what we're objecting to? Or maybe we see the whole pageant celebrating a history of empire, international inhumanity, slavery, genocide, and selling that to the people as something to get patriotic about. But no one here feels patriotic about it. Not about the loot taken from so many nations, and not about our stone of destiny. Or rather, the lump of Perth sandstone that has stood for English claims to overlordship of Scotland for the past 700 years. So here's an idea. Instead of bewailing our stone of destiny getting taken away, how about we turn the whole thing round? What Charles will be crowned on is a fake. Probably a pudgy stake. So how about laughing instead of crying about it? Imagine if instead of standing like an obedient lackey to the side of the royal lump of stone, Humza had pointed at it, laughed his head off and walked away. And by the way, Salvo's thinking of presenting his English majesty with a golden loo roll to go with the royal lavish thing. Maybe we reject the ostentatious wealth and privilege, the scene of extravagance, when so many people in this toxic union are destitute, hungry, homeless, and sick. Maybe it's all that and something more. Maybe your gut tells you something else is terribly wrong with what happened today, but you don't know exactly what. Well, I'd like to tell you what your gut knows. An English monarch took an English oath and imposed the institution of the English crown across Britain. And that is a crime against this nation and this kingdom of Scotland, against every Scot alive today and every Scot who ever lived and died for what it means to be a Scot. Because what it means to be a Scot is to be the crown of Scotland. That is what still guarantees that the people of Scotland are sovereign. They are the sovereign crown of the nation. And this union, brought about by a forced treaty that the English establishment had no intention of ever honouring, has never had the lawful right to touch the crown of Scotland or anything it owns. Some people say this is all ancient history, all over and done with. If you believe that, I have news for you. Scotland's oil and gas, our water and our renewables, are plundered now, today, in right of the crown. Not some joint crown created for the brand new union in United Kingdom in 1707, but the same old English crown that has always coveted Scotland. That crown says it all belongs to His English Majesty. Not the Scottish crown, which is the people. That's how they take our oil and gas and renewables and water and all the rest today. And that's why we're paying so much for what we already own. Scotland never came under the rule of the English crown in 1707 because no queen or parliament, English or Scottish, and no treaty they made had the power to extinguish the Scottish crown or replace it with England's. And the British establishment knows that.
300 years of military control, cultural, legal, social and physical genocide has been trying to wipe out Scotland's collective memory. Wipe out the record of the terms and limits of a bogus treaty, but one England agreed and is bound to. Wipe out the memory of a people that they were and are the Crown of Scotland. But I've news for that establishment. Scotland is waking up. Scotland remembers, and Scotland is rising. I'm sorry for keeping you. I've just a wee bit to do. What's important here is that no nation in the world has ever achieved liberation without a powerful sense of its own identity. And there's no more powerful clue to our identity than the truth that we are together, the Crown of Scotland. That we are the power in this nation and we can shape our destiny. As Salvo says, know your past, shape your future. How do we do it? Salvo's working to support a liberation movement and an international campaign to expose this union as a fraud. A fraud. Look underneath. Lift up the Union Jack. You know what you'll find? Just the English establishment strutting around in disguise, as vicious towards their own people as all the other so-called lower classes of the world. If you've not signed up for liberation or Salvo, do and get your friends and family to do it as well. But that alone won't set us free. I can't tell you exactly what the eventual route to freedom is going to look like. But I can tell you it will take all of us together. And we can start, those of us that are left, here and now. No one here is SNP or ISP or ALBA or any other party, because we can't be our beliefs. That's the whole gender reform thing, that you can be something because you believe it, and we all know that's not true, right? Beliefs can change. What we are is what can't change. What we are is Scots. That cannot change, and that's what unites us. So, you've heard, everybody's heard about the invitation we were all taking. We were all given to take the feudal oath to His Most English Majesty. An invitation to commit treachery against the nation of Scotland and ourselves by surrendering our sovereignty to an English crown. How dare they? So, how about sending Scotland's answer? So I have a few words. They've been taken and expanded from the legally required Scottish Oath of Accession. That's the one Charles won't take. If I say it line by line, will you say it with me?
Yes.
I faithfully promise.
I faithfully promise.
The lawful rights and rents.
The lawful rights and rents.
With all just privileges.
With all just privileges.
Of the Crown of Scotland, which is the people of this nation.
Of the Crown of Scotland, which is the people of this nation.
I shall claim.
I shall claim.
I shall call to account.
I shall call to account.
All those who have betrayed, transferred, or undermined it.
All those who have betrayed, transferred, or undermined it.
Theft. And wrongdoing.
Death, oppression, wrongdoing.
Against this people.
Against this people.
I shall answer with justice, equity, and the restoration of our rights.
I shall answer with justice.
Of our laws and the common good of our sovereign community.
The laws and the common good of our sovereign community.
So help me.
Help me.
Now, I was going to say, let's give ourselves a round of applause, but instead let's do something else. Let's turn around to whoever's around you, beside you, and if you're a hugger, hug, and if you're a handshaker, shake hands. Let's
Scotland remembers, and Scotland is rising. Forward.
ahead of the politicians and tell them to follow us. The days of idle arguing on social media are over. The days of labels, party hats, and exclusive clubs are done. Everyone is a contributor on this journey. Everyone must advance the cause. Take the time you have, take the time you can. Focus on an idea or an issue that you are passionate about. Do the research, write a document. Take that document and share it. Everyone must share their work. It's the progression of ideas that count, not copyright, but contribution. Elevate ourselves from the petty criticism by becoming our own editorial team. No more, "Oh, but that's rubbish." Help improve it or write better.
Ask your fears, ask your friends their fears and their concerns. Ask them to tell you why they're not convinced yet to yes. Then help build the documents and the arguments that will solve the problem. We have no opposition, we have a boundless future to write. Every time the unionists point out a flaw, a concern or a soundbite, they do us a favour. It gives us the opportunity to improve our plan, to make our ship more tight. We need to embrace our critical friends. We need to have a wider door and longer table. We need to build the perspective together. None of this needs a massive organisation. None of this needs a political party. None of this needs guidance from those in power. The truth is that the people are who the politicians fear.
The people are where ideas are born. The people are who dream. The people are who make demands. So today, invite the politicians to follow you. Support and celebrate those who go home today and start writing. Iterate and build on those ideas. Improve them with your contribution. The ideas of tomorrow will be written today. The future is not yet written. It has always been in our hands. So pick up your pen, your keyboard, or your mic. Take control. Make a stand. Write your own future. The first words after the French Revolution were "Vive la France!" In the spirit of the Old Alliance, let the first words of our Scottish independent nation be "Vive la France!"
Those of us who dare to dream, plan, deliver a better future as one. We're dauntless, brave and loyal, valiant to the end. If you came here a stranger, you will surely exit a friend.
Okay, hello everyone. We've got one more speaker and one more music act and then we're done. It's great to see so many people still here at the end. It's been raining and all the rest of it, so well done. So next up we've got David Henry of the Scottish Sovereignty Research Group. Big round of applause for David, please.
Hi folks, thanks for sticking around so long. So hello Glasgow. This is Edinburgh calling. Right, we're all here for one reason. And that reason is to support Scotland's future and to see Scotland become independent. When I voted yes, which believe it or not, when I voted yes, on the 18th of September 2014, I then joined the SNP the next day. Never voted for them before. when do we want it? The SSRG published two documents in the last year. One is the Claim of Right, and the other is the Treaty of Union. We also held, as many of you might know, last year, a three-day conference in Dunfermline. Many of you might have been there. Thank you for your support. We're doing it again this year, on the 14th to 16th of July, again the same venue, only it's going to be bigger and better than last year. We have already invited is organising its three-day independence convention, on the 14th to 16th. It's open to all politicians, experts, academics, and most importantly, it's open to all supporters of Scottish independence. So as many of you as possible, please try and come along. We'll also make it available online. One, Scotland can be a fairer, more equal country. We don't need to accept 200% increases in our electricity bills. We can have a publicly owned energy company that will benefit every Scottish household. You just need to vote for it. Scotland can join EFTA within months, not years. That gives you access to all the EU trade deals. Nation can be in charge of its future once again. You just need to vote for it. Scotland can have a central bank. It can have its own currency. You just need to vote for it. So the SSRG conference is the next step of the Yes movement. In July, we're going to bring representatives and supporters from the SNP, ISP, and our friends, family and neighbours who are still supporters of the Union. Let us all get together and help build a better country. It's time we all work together. It's time we voted for independence. I want to see you there in July. Thank you.
Thanks, David. So before the last person on the stage, we've got Andy Docherty just about to play some songs. So the next march is in Stirling on 24th of June, and then it's Ayr on the 29th of July, and onwards up to Edinburgh on the 7th of October. So this is online, it's on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, all the dates. Let's keep this momentum going, let's get to Stirling, and let's carry this on. It's a massive march on the 24th of June. Look forward to seeing you there. Thank you.
farewell to all.